countless Christians across the world are persecuted because of their faith. And this persecution can take many different forms: oppression, displacement, martyrdom, and imprisonment. Being imprisoned for your faith means suffering injustice, losing your freedom, being separated from your church and family, and facing the prospect of mistreatment from prison authorities and fellow inmates. In China, the church is under pressure from the communist authorities, and the number of Christians being detained for their faith has increased dramatically. Pastor Wang Yi is currently serving a 9-year prison sentence, and on the outside, his family are under constant surveillance. In Eritrea, many Christians have been incarcerated for their faith over the last 20 years. Dr. Kiflu Gebremeskel has been in prison since 2004. He has never been brought to trial, and he has been prevented from seeing his wife and 4 children for long periods. In Pakistan, Christians are vulnerable to false allegations of blasphemy. This can result in long detentions without trial and, in some cases, a death sentence. Zafar Bhatti was falsely accused of sending a blasphemous text message and has now been in prison for more than a decade. In the New Testament book of Hebrews, the writer tells us to remember those in prison as if we were together with them. So on this International Day of Prayer for the Persecuted Church, we commit to remember those in prison for their faith as if we were with them. We count them as family, we stand with them, and we pray for them. Through our network of international partners, Release International is helping to support Christian prisoners of faith and their families with legal aid, practical provisions, and pastoral care in several countries across the world.